Hello everybody, now let us go on to the second skill, which is the skill of explanation. I've actually written the components of the skill of explanation. Now the first component is beginning statement. Now after the motivation, the next step, the second step is the skill of explanation. So when you begin to explain, you cannot say, now I'm going to explain about so and so. Instead of saying that, you can say, let us now go into this lesson and try to understand what the author is trying to say. Now, this kind of a statement can be said if you're doing a prose lesson or even a kind of a story type, even if it's going to be non-detail or something like that, or even a model story session. But if it's going to be prose, now let us all enjoy reading this poetry. So this type of little phrases or little sentences at the beginning would be the beginning statement. And when we do the skill of explanation, we should have clarity. Now, let me continue with the same example. The lesson is Balu and the Apple Tree. This is normally done for grade 3 or grade 4. This is a prose lesson. So how am I going to give the beginning statement? I will tell them that, I will ask them to close all their books, and then I will ask them to sit down in a very relaxed mode, because we are going to have story time. And so that itself would, you know, gear them up where they'll put their pencil boxes, their books all aside, and they will sit down to listen to my story. And when I start the story, I may involve a child. I will call the child forward and give him a character. In this particular example, I will name the child Balu. I will call another student forward and name him the tree. Because in this lesson, we have just two people. One is Balu and one is the tree. For this, I as a teacher should have studied the lesson, should have understood every concept. Only then I can really do this as a perfect role model in front of my children. So I will have a student who is Balu, one student as a tree. And as I read or as I narrate, I will ask these two people to act according to the statements. So now what is happening? I'm stimulating my children to watch and to listen. Of course, the teacher needs to have fluency. In case the fluency is missing, the enthusiasm is lost. So when we prepare for the skill of explanation, maybe if you're not very well versed in English, you can write out your script and decide what statement you're going to make during the process of explanation. Use of linked words. This is very important because sometimes when we speak continuously, we are lost in thought what to say next. So the link words like however, because, since, later on, these type of words will bring in a tone of narration to the listener. Then you go on for planned repetition. While you explain, in this lesson, I want to emphasize that the tree was extremely very generous. So I want to build in the quality of generosity in my children. So I would intentionally keep repeating, the tree was very generous. The tree gave away its apples. Now let me tell you the story. There was a small boy just like you, and his name was Balu. I was telling you just now, his name was Balu. This boy was very playful. He had a few friends, but he chose the tree to be his friend. Now, this story is based on imagination, because do trees talk to us? No, they don't. So this story is based on pure imagination. Can you imagine a tortoise talking to you? Yes. But will the tortoise really talk to you? Not at all. So this is an example where the writer of the story just imagines and develop this particular story. Now, Balu is a small boy where he used to come to engage himself to play along with the tree. So while playing, the tree and Balu, they have small conversations. The boy then starts going to school. And when he comes back from school, he does not have toys because his parents did not buy toys. So he comes with a complaint to his friend. You know, you have friends who are ready to help you when you need. So he comes and tells his friend, I need to buy some toys and I do not have money. So the tree tells him, you can take away all my apples. Go sell it in the market and you will get money. With that, you can buy toys. So Balu takes the apples, goes to the market, sells it, gets money, buys his toy. And with that, he doesn't come back to the tree. Then Balu grows a little more big. And he now comes to him saying that, I need some more help because now I am big and I need more support from you. So the tree now decides, it starts thinking, what kind of support can I give? But I like Balu. He's my best friend. I should help him out. So the story goes on like this. Now, coming back to the teacher trainee, what you can do is you can have a child here who will pretend to be the tree, keep his hands up. Or if you don't want to use the child keeping his hands up to pretend like a tree, you can draw a chart. You can draw a tree on a chart with apples which can be removable. So the first episode where Balu is plucking the apple, you can really pull out the apple if you use some sticker and stick it. The picture of the apple can be just withdrawn and given to Balu. So then Balu really goes to the market. We can create the market scene where Balu is selling the apples, and we can, you know, bring in the usage of math where he sells 1 kilo of apple for 60 rupees and then he gets that 60 rupees and goes to the toy shop. So we can really create a lovely scene while we do this explanation. So then coming back to the story, Balu comes again to the tree and asks him for help, and the tree decides to give his branches because he would like to build a house. So likewise, Balu comes to the tree at various situations and utilizes the tree completely. The first time he came was he said he wants to buy toys. The tree gave its apples. The second time he came and said he needs to build a house. So the tree decided to give its branches. So in case you're using a child to stand like this as the branches, so one branch is cut off, other branch is cut off. So only the tree is there now. So what happened to the branches? He's built a house for himself. And many years later, he doesn't come back. Many years pass by and he doesn't come. After that, when he's little old, he comes back to the tree. And now only the stump is left. There's no fruits, there's no leaves, there's no branch. Only the stump is there. And if you're using a chart, you can use the, you know, the Velcro where you can remove the branches. So only the trunk of the tree remains on your chart. Now again, he comes to the tree and the tree is so happy to see Balu after so many years and says, come Balu, let's engage in playing, let's engage in talking. And then again Balu says, no, I'm too old to sit down and talk with you because you yourself are gone very old. I need a boat where I can go to different places and enjoy myself. So then the tree decides to give away its trunk. So the trunk also is cut off. Now the trunk is cut off and what's remaining? Only the roots. Only the roots. Have you seen trees like this? So the children will answer, yes, yes. Where did you see? How many trees? What do you think of it? Do you think there's a story behind those trees? You bring interaction among the children. Coming back to our lesson, so the tree decides to give away its trunk, and Balu goes, makes a boat, he goes all over the place, goes boating, enjoys himself. And now it's time for him to become very, very, very old. You know, we have our grandparents, we have our great-grandparents. How do they walk? Like this. Some of them walk like this. Some of them are even more bent, right? They've gone very old. So Balu also became very old. Now, wait a minute. Do we all grow old? Yes. Even when you come back after you become a big girl or a big boy, I will be old. Later on, you will also become old. So this is the process of life. Coming back to our story, Balu is now very old and he comes to his tree. And even now, the tree friend says, come Balu, you are my friend. What can I do for you? Why are you so sad? So then Balu tells him, oh no, I need some rest. I'm very tired. I need to rest my body on something. So then the tree offers its root as a support. So Balu goes there and sits down and stretches his legs, two legs, right? You know, and slants his head on the tree. I should have actually drawn this a little closer, maybe this way, where he rests his head on this and, you know, sit down with his legs. So what happened to this story? The tree has been a very generous friend. It has been very supportive to Balu. Whether Balu did good to it or not, whether Balu spent time with him or not, the tree completely gave up itself for friendship. Generosity is very important. So likewise, children, are you going to be generous when you grow big? The children may tell you yes or no. Pull up some questions. Ask them, what kind of generosity are you going to do? Or you can even bring out the concept of saving trees. So this is how you go about the skill of explanation. Stimulating questions. I just did this concept to you. And then the concluding statements. The concluding statement is, you can wind up by saying that the tree was extremely kind. So kindness is close to, kindness is something very pure. It's actually close to God. God's act, God is always very kind to us. So you can connect it to a godly aspect. So I think this example should be helpful to you. Thank you.